Calvin technically has an
L-A-N. Kaplan.
Rubbles. It also doesn't have that much ammo, maybe. And it's not RE, it's RS.
Yeah.
Yay for a rubble symbol.
Okay. Alright, so you guys are good, everyone else is good. Ready to start the timer.
So, just as some advice, Mike, you've been told to hit your opponent's ships. That's what Patrick has said in Twitch chat. Yeah. I'm assuming that's what he means, just knock him off a table. Yep, should be. So, an interesting enough asteroid placement.
Someone at 3-1 who does not make.
Yeah, it's actually it would impossible for it to be a clean cut with the results we'd had.
So it actually means that.
Right, when you rolled up with that weird squad in school, what is this?
Yeah, it actually means Mike can't make it.
Why is it so bad?
Aiden's name is spelled with an A and not an E.
Okay, give me a second to finish trying to fix this.
Sorry.
Let me... Okay, that's still not perfect. Stupid Inquisitor.
Oh, names aren't backwards.
I've fixed that one already. Aid and.
Yeah. There we go. Now we're rocking. I'm gonna take this opportunity to go and make the gift cards.
Okay, have fun. Stay safe.
You wanna do one random one? Or. Yeah, I'll do it random.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm just going to turn the scoreboard off for a little bit, guys. That's why we've got ships up in that corner. Oh, the table's massively not straight anymore. I'm going to have to fix that for a cut. One bank from a shuttle. Which is going to be matched by the waffle rebel.
Perform one attack and then perform zero.
one personalized one as well. Omega Leader's got the target, the invade token established already. So an aggressive move for Maiden with dash, trying to get him right into a fight. That's the correct choice now, you see if you can get the target lock. Make sure you don't need to waste any actions repositioning. I don't know that I would have done that one, because you're going to take a second stress from the debris, probably. Oh no, it's dash. What am I talking about? I'm just being a moron. I know you can hear me. That's why I say stuff after you've done it. That's why it's called commentating and not predicting. Yeah. Yeah. Being a horrible person to a player is, that's what being a commentator is all about. Aggressive movement from the Inquisitor. Can't see the angle for the arc from the Lawful Rebel at the moment, but hopefully he's got out if he's going to do that move. And establishes the target lock on the Ghost. So Omega Leader onto the Lawful Rebel. So yep, so Duke happens. What? Okay, so it didn't do the EPT though. So all that's happened so far is Mike shot the Ghost with Omega Leader. And didn't use Duke.
Ah.
So no damage was dealt. And then the Inquisitor shot and also didn't.
Did the Inquisitor go one forward?
No.
Didn't think so. Because that's not on the dial. Never tell which way the stupid YT 2400 is facing towards
the debris. Yeah. So I said stupid things like I wouldn't have pushed her if his dash was going to be double stressed for flying over debris, and then remembered it was dash.
Excellent.
So that's the shield gone from Omega Leader.
Alright.
Okay.
So didn't miss very much.
So the grand total of that turn was one damage onto Omega Leader. And did the Lawful take any damage? And one shield off the Lawful Rebel. Should be a more productive turn for Mike. Let's see, should definitely be able to get the Shuttle and Wampa into a fight as well.
Yeah, Omega Leader and the Inquisitor got a little ahead of the game. dash out of range.
Dash shot at Omega Leader. Only got two hits, I think it was, which was evaded with Palpatine. Yeah, three hits for Palpatine and the evade token, so.
Strip that at least.
Mike forgot Duke anyway, so.
I won't forget next time, maybe.
I should actually check that that's what's on Mike's list, if you don't mind, because I just assumed.
I'm pretty sure. Look, Duke and Comrie are there.
Yeah, that's okay. I'm just making sure, you know. Yeah. I don't want to be negligent.
You can all order thrust to serve you one, yeah. It is a standard A-holes list.
So, goes and lands on the debris, which should leave enough space for Inquisitor's inevitable hard one.
Is that Inquisitor missing a wing?
Yes.
It's gonna make it hard to fly.
It's a force user. Just
use the force.
Yep.
The shot from dash was palped.
Yes.
So that it did no damage. Just to answer Patrick.
I'd already told him. So, I feel like I would have slammed Wampa into the back of Omega Leader rather than turning him out of a fight. Just doing a two forwards would have bumped into Omega Leader, but at least you're pointing at the ghost. And if the ghost starts shooting Wampa, oh well.
Aiden deciding whether to push with dash.
He's going to push.
Rich is abusing you in the Facebook group.
Pardon?
Rich is abusing you in the Facebook group.
Abusing me?
Yeah.
I'm not even playing.
Well, his comment is that you have the same number of points as if you were playing.
Alright. Technically, a did not enter is at an infinite number of points. Technically,
so,
under my logic.
So everyone in the world who is not in the event actually has infinite points. Okay.
In the same way that.
How do I split that prize?
You give it all to me, and I'll sort it out.
Okay.
I feel like zero and infinity should be interchangeable. This is a philosophical context,
yeah,
not a mathematical context.
I was going to say, as someone who studied maths, I'm going to say no. Zero and infinity, not interchangeable.
Both, you know, unachievable.
So it looks like Omega Leader switched the target lock onto dash, having turned hard turn towards dash.
I'm gonna just point out that I hope Greg really, really appreciates the amount of abuse I take because I conceded now and my final standings were terrible compared to if I'd have just crushed him. I would have made the top 16 and I could have got some funky, doesn't even fit custom mine tokens.
You could. Or you might have got crushed.
It was terrible. So bad. One hit. Spends the target lock.
One damage, having spent the token. Interesting. Can't tell if the Lothariba also has arc on the Inquisitor.
It
from him.
Rear arc to turn off. I can't tell from the angle.
I guess Dash was target locked on the Inquisitor, so.
Oh, you're gonna fire the auto blaster turret anyway. So it doesn't
That's
matter if it's arced or not, unless you roll double crit.
That's a good point. Any damage? No damage. So, taking the primary range one shot, has the target lock.
Actually, I'm gonna use Han to just switch those.
Oh dear.
That looks
ominous. Five hits from.
Looks like a dead Omega leader.
So, that's.
Palp.
Yeah.
Still alive with Palp. That was fortunate. Needed to roll two.
Yeah.
And Palp one. Yeah, had that same HLC thing from earlier.
Yep.
As it turned out, it didn't matter because it was all evaded, but...
So, Omega Leader switched the target lock onto Dash and then spent the target lock, I think?
Yes. It was on Dash, but spent.
You don't want to leave the target lock on Dash because then the HRC hurts.
That's a good point. It did let Aiden spend his focus token for defense. But, yeah.
But it gives the opportunity to do damage.
But as it was, Dash fired on the Inquisitor anyway, because he had a target lock on him. I think...
I'm just going to check, make sure I didn't...
Squeaky chair. So, just checking if this 5k fits. It's going to be very close. Just squeaked by. So that was a tough choice last turn with the shooting. I would have been tempted to put everything in Omega Leader, but he went after the Inquisitor with Dash because he had the target lock. But with Omega Leader having spent the target lock on the attack, I would have been tempted to just unload. Although I'm not sure, I think it might actually have been at range 1, so that might have been one reason why. Thinking back, I think Omega Leader rolled 3 dice.
Yeah, it did roll 3 dice.
So it was range 1, so Dash couldn't. Had to shoot someone else.
Yeah. Well, at least one first point in the right way now.
Looks like a bump.
Into Wampa.
Into Wampa.
Wampa. Omega Leader should be feeling pretty safe. So,
little sloop. Inquisitor on the debris from the exit.
That is not good.
And roll 4 damage on the debris.
No, it's fine. Yeah, Inquisitor onto a wall 4. Yeah, spends the target lock.
Better.
Hit crit. So the front of his base doesn't go over, so.
Direct hit.
So that will be half points.
So, what do you choose to do this time for if you're Aiden?
Aiden, you pile up for an entry Inquisitor.
Do you not try and finish off Omega Leader with the Ghost?
No. Not when you've got Inquisitor sat there, looks to be ranged. I suppose if it's range 2 for the Lawful, shoot the Inquisitor. If it's range 3...
Well, I suppose Dash is going to have to shoot the Inquisitor,
yeah.
So it'll depend on what happens with that. Omega Leader stressed. I don't know. You know how much of a pain in the ass she can be.
Yeah. Did Dash lose 4 shields, sir?
It's the last word.
It was 4 shields. Yeah, you have to go up the Inquisitor.
Well, Dash has to. I mean, his only other option is the shuttle, so... 2 hits. Double thrusters. So, honestly, I think I would...
Well, you try and draw out Palpatine on that shot, and then hope that you can smash through. There you go, so there's the choice.
I think, you know, the chance to try and kill a ship.
Yeah. No, I get it. I suppose he already has a target lock as well.
Only needs 1.
Oh, you were right and I was wrong.
The fact that he had the target lock, I think, was
probably
a deciding factor.
Again, I suppose if Dash puts 2 damage on the Inquisitor, then...
It's a different choice then.
Because
then if it's range 2 and Inquisitor...
Doesn't have auto thrusters.
Yeah. But it would have been an unmodified attack, so...
Yeah.
As it is, Omega Leader's gone. And that's Nice.
It's still a game. The dash has taken enough damage that Wampa and the Inquisitor can do nasty things to him.
Yeah. And I'm only on six now.
The shuttle's undamaged, so. And you're never gonna. Sorry, you should never get another turn where the Inquisitor is sitting in front of you with no actions.
Not unless you can block him. So.
Show the shuttle. I'd do a hard two into dash.
I think he was stressed from a stop last time. I think.
I took the opportunity to run to a washroom, so.
Yeah, I think he was stressed. Like, I don't remember him moving at all before the Wathel Rebel ended that 5k. So. Yeah, the Inquisitor has got a bit of traffic in front of him.
He's going to have dialed in the hard one. I'm not saying it's the right move, but that's what I would have dialed in.
Well, obviously he knew where his own shuttle was going.
Yeah.
Wampa, probably K-turning.
That's 4K, I think.
Yeah, I think.
Just yeah. Marking the corner with dash on.
And if the Inquisitor does it hard and ends up back on the.
So dash.
He destroyed 17. I can enter it if you guys are commentating.
117.
Apparently it's just I win player of the year.
So
first result in, Calvin continues his winning streak.
It's
not
two really.
Whole games.
He's 4-0 now, two buys, and has won his next two. So
I'm here to commentate for the rest of this round. Because this is fun.
We don't want you.
Aww.
So Dash is going after the Inquisitor. Looks like a Toggle focus push. And that is a bump.
I can leave if you want. I can leave if you want.
No, it's
no,
okay.
No.
Yeah. You're quite welcome to stay.
So, Inquisitor.
I dropped just to keep from making some poor person at 1 and 2 feel the wrath of Triple Jump Master.
So, just for the benefit of people who aren't going to have Twitch chat, it's just been pointing out that even if Calvin wins this event, anyone who goes 1 bye and 2 losses at regionals and then drops shouldn't be allowed to call themselves player of the year. That isn't a sentiment I can support, obviously. We don't hold anything against people. Especially when Calvin dropping meant he could commentate and me and Greg could take breaks.
Yeah.
So. Exactly. I mean, I could have played and clubbed Baby Seals, but that would have been cruel. And this way I allowed you guys to take breaks.
So, three hits from Dash.
I dropped with the noblest of intentions.
Looks like.
And then
one.
Should be auto thrusters for the other one.
I don't know if it's range 2.
This is from Dash's shot. So So it should be auto thrusters and Palpatine should save him.
You have to remember their own things.
Auto thrusters isn't amazing.
I'm pretty sure it is.
Okay.
I've actually deliberately not used auto thrusters to allow my Poe to die to deny Whisper a shot to recloak.
Yeah.
It was a next level play.
So, range one on the Inquisitor from the Lothal Rebel. It's two hits.
So, if I didn't remember to reestablish a target lock. Oh no, he shot at Omega Leader, didn't he?
He did. Shields down. So, he did force the Palp use on the shot from Dash, which.
Yep,
so
all you can ask for with
the. Strips the shields.
Painful.
And I'm assuming Wampa didn't do anything? No damage?
Wampa did not, because Palpatine wasn't there to push it through.
It's okay, Paul. We're
did
not
the Inquisitor do
you.
Any damage to. What did the Inquisitor shoot at? Did it?
He did two more, I think. Oh.
Yeah. So.
Made some good damage.
Oh, if a ghost dies and then the Inquisitor.
Because he really wanted that five.
The auto blaster was a better choice. Sorry, the primary was a better choice.
Primary. Yeah, it was unmodified, so.
Yeah, five against, nothing to defend.
Yeah, 5 against 3 unmodified, no pulp.
Yeah.
That's actually true. When all the tokens are gone.
I would much rather have taken the 5 dice, because then you can explode the Inquisitor, whereas in the Auto Blaster it's impossible to kill him.
That's true.
Yeah.
But that's why I lose games.
Hey, sometimes a high percentage play pays off for you.
Yeah.
It did for me. The IGs that you guys just watched do pretty well. Their dice luck ran out.
Well, they did use quite a bit of luck.
Yeah, in the last round. They used a lot of luck.
But unfortunately, that MOV might be pretty punishing. Oh, we'll wait and see.
Zuckus landed a triple crit shot to Hull. Very painful.
Ooh.
3 crits to Hull.
So you didn't just fly Zuckus straight into a giant trap this time?
Surprisingly, I actually learned how to play Zuckus.
It's a better list, isn't it? I think it's a better list anyway.
Five versus three unmodified.
Average on two unmodified is one.
Yeah.
And exactly. You use that sort of logic.
But what's the maximum damage you can do from your auto blaster turret?
Exactly. Well, the thing is, the auto blaster's average is actually less too. It's only one. It's a modified.
It's less than one, because crits don't.
Oh, you're right. So. The crits can be dodged.
Yeah.
So it's less than one. So it's actually somewhere around half the potential. It's only 3 eights, guaranteed. Yeah.
Structural damage. Oh.
Oh, no. Agility 0?
Yep.
Oh, sad times.
To a minimum of 0.
Yeah, that's not the worst crit to get on a VCX.
But he didn't have target lock established. On an unmodified shot, if you have a choice between rolling 5 dice or 2, take the 5.
Better variance. Because 2 has such a high chance of just giving you nothing.
Yeah.
like 30% where you just do nothing.
So. Apparently, I can hear us talking on the TV now.
Yeah.
Never.
Castception.
I don't think the barrel rolls. The barrel might fit if he wants one pump.
Boost?
Boosting.
All
the pegs.
I think I would have sent Wampa to try and kill the ghost. Because the Inquisitor shouldn't get a shot on it this turn.
Yeah. That just means that the Lothal Rebel is just going to unload into that shuttle. Unless Inquisitor's within range 1.
Yeah, in which case.
Then you go for your auto blast the turret.
That is fun!
Because now he's got the target lock.
I'm actually saying that sarcastically, I do enjoy that. It's
awesome. Okay, you told me.
What?
Nothing.
Chris loves math too.
Hooray, math relevant.
I don't. It's not that I don't like math, it's that I don't feel the need to sit down and do it. I don't need to know that the average of 5 dice into 3 unmodified is 1.5 and the average of 2 is only 0.8. Because I know that it's a better shot. I don't know, I don't come up with numbers that this one's better.
Well, strictly speaking, those are not actually the best ways to analyze the results.
No.
Anyways,
and
because, like,
you want to know the potential of what could happen.
This is not a strict. This is not like a very strict binary thing. It's actually like not a distribution. So,
yeah. You want to cover more the most of the bell curve as you can.
Yeah.
The more of the curve that has preferential results for you, the better.
The trick about the math is you have to understand what it represents.
Yes.
It represents an abstraction of probability space.
At any given time, you get 0 hits on a trillion dice. If you're me.
Gambler's ruin. If you roll dice often enough, you will get the streak that wipes you out.
Yep.
Happened to Ian last round.
Did it? Did it ever?
It did.
Had to happen eventually.
It did.
I'm going to go back and watch that one.
I felt bad.
See what happened.
I felt bad for him.
Oh, if you felt bad for him, it must have been disastrous.
It was the difference between a guaranteed win and a probable loss over the course of a number of turns, just needing to do 1 damage.
We've all had that game.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever had more than 1 game that was that bad. But I've chased Chewie with 1 hull remaining with 5 TIE fighters and then lost a game because Chewie popped 3 of my TIE fighters and I didn't kill Chewie.
Yep. I had a game where I removed a defender before rolling an evade result, a successful evade result. And all it was coming in at 1 to 2 dice. It was coming in at like 2 to 3 dice attacks.
Yeah. No, I mean, I think, you know, obviously you can calculate for any given situation what the math is.
Yeah.
And it may help your decision making process.
It can tell you what the statistical best choice is, and that's pretty much it.
But I won't sit there and calculate it. You can usually tell I have these 2 options available. This one feels better.
Sometimes it is a trap.
Often it's clear, sometimes it's not. But even, you know, if things are that close, well, then neither option is really the better or worse.
Well, sometimes, though, you actually do have to play to your out. Sometimes you need to fish for that 15% chance, and that's the only way you win the game.
Right.
Like, this is more common in, like, card games, where it's like, okay, if I don't top deck Wrath of God, or if I don't top deck Tyrion Forgering now,
you've got to shoot for a river.
Yeah. So you might as well, you know what? If that's it, it's like, you know, you might as well go for it, because sometimes you draw the Helix and just look like a champion.
But then in that case, like, the decision is made for you. You only have the one.
Also,
yeah. Thing.
You play to your
The
average.
Skill is recognizing that.
Yeah.
Right.
You play to realizing, okay, the only way I win is if I draw something off the top of my deck, so I play as if I'm going to draw that thing off the top of my deck.
Right.
It's like me, the only way I win is if all of my dice roll like they statistically should. If my dice roll within the bell curve, I win. Oh, I've lost again. Oh, Sentai.
Alright. Well, that Hawk Shuttle might actually contribute this turn. Aside from being a boat for the Emperor.
So.
But you know that by. So Aiden's saying that he wants his dice to suck, which means he wants them to roll a crit. Because
yeah.
In this instance, that 1 in 8 chance is what would suck.
Tell that to Witch.
Shut up. You still. Sad times. Aiden didn't kill himself. Sad times.
This time.
Wow.
There's no bias in this commentary, but when Aiden loses, I'm going to be so happy. So he's referencing a game we had in Myth Games a while ago now, where he took Wedge down from like 5 health to 1. With an A-wing shot, and I had to integrate BB-8, which meant that the asteroid I was planning on barrel rolling around, I had to then fly over. So the asteroid obviously killed me.
Yep.
So Wedge died to a ranged 1 A-wing shot and then a rock.
Oh, Chris.
Well, there's nothing unlikely about that.
There's nothing impossible about that.
It's gonna happen.
You know, everyone should thank me for soaking up all of these anomalies, because if it wasn't for me, it might happen to you.
That's not how the probability works!
No. Yeah, shut it, fan. Ah, dear.
Alright, this is going to look like a potentially strong turn for Aiden, because only a couple of those ties are likely to contribute here, I think. Or, sorry, one of those ties is going to contribute. Off of it looks like he's not going to do crap.
But the Wathel Rebel has no shot.
I think that's fine. It's about to die anyway, so
yeah,
I think its lack of a shot is not material.
It is dead.
It's just going to soak up the Inquisitor's shot.
Bye.
Crunch.
So, Mike didn't take the evade from his option to target lock, and just spent a needless focus token.
Well, he's not getting a shot back, I don't think.
Dash should be able to shoot.
It's like
I don't
range.
Know.
Oh, maybe it wasn't range, I guess.
Okay, so it's going at Palpatine.
Yeah, we don't know why Mike spent the focus.
Wanted to make sure with extra damage above and beyond the necessary.
He really only needed the one. It was an unobstructed shot, right?
Yeah.
Unobstructed, range 1.
So, 2 hits onto the bolt shuttle. Shield's gone off the bolt shuttle.
So, half point.
Indeed.
40.
What's he got?
Hayden pulls into...
Within 2 points.
No.
40. Huh? Huh?
He's up to 40.
Yeah, he's up to 40, so no, not really just yet. Here comes Wampa.
So.
Away she goes.
So half points for dash.
Yeah.
29 puts him at 71. And one from the shuttle as well.
Oh, that dream bolt. The dream bolt shuttle doing work.
I think you should try and turn to follow dash or just turn into the board now.
The problem with is that was the one turn the shuttle was going to have shooting for a while.
Yeah, and I'm saying which direction do you think you should go for the chase to push dash further over or just turn around to look for next turn? For the next
I would probably turn. Dial in one bank to the right this round. Because if dash goes slow, you put Palpatine in range one of the HOC. If Aiden goes the wrong way, you might get a shot. It clears your stress, and that allows you the hard two next turn in whichever direction you need.
At best, he's only ever going to play.
Yeah, but one bank, the stress.
Basically,
he's never going to have that shot. So.
The Inquisitor needs to not die to this HLC shot.
So it's to put
it
tokens.
To put it simply.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm 100% certain that a one bank and then a hard two will still keep the shuttle on the board. Because a one bank should actually bump into dash or be just in line and in front of it.
But it will be. Will it be useful? I think you. Yeah, I think chasing him might be actually the better probability because he's near a corner. He's going to have to turn. So if you can turn the corner, if you can grab the corner tight enough, then you might be able to actually keep it.
To a rock,
interesting.
Not more importantly, does not
bump. Doesn't bump. No, he's got space. Or maybe it did bump.
It did bump.
That is definitely another choice. Regardless,
I don't think it's horrible.
Just because of the lack of angling. Like, if you want to occupy that spot, I would take a bank just to...
Well, it depends what you've dialed in for Inquisitor.
Fair enough. Because that position also doesn't block any long moves that dash might look to make.
As long as he gets a shot with Wampa, you're hoping that it's at least a guaranteed point of damage.
Yeah, even if the one bank clips the debris, that's not even my...
But I don't think he was going to block him.
Yeah.
And
so that's why I thought maybe you should bank into the board and then just keep banking into the board and then turn around.
No, now we can hard turn
maybe
to the left. And
I would, his left. Yeah, shuttle's
left. Shuttle's left. If dash heads up the table,
so
then the shuttle might be able to come around.
Target lock, see if he remembers the evade action this time.
Nope. Good old B1.
Yeah. Nope. And that's just him putting the focus token down. It comes in the pack, so it definitely has it. The V1 title.
Yeah, there's no way.
It's on the list.
There's no way you would own an advanced from.
So three hits on dash from Inquisitor.
It's
only two hits get through. Well, so let's see if Wampa's shot is in range. Well, after dash shoots, obviously.
Yeah, actually, the term that I rolled up there was one delta. Traditionally, how we built one delta. And I'm like, and he gave me a bunch of good stories. And like I said, I'll not know.
You need to draw out the Palpatine to not take a guaranteed point of damage here.
Yeah.
So,
learn
Yeah, still the best shot at.
So, three hits from...
Is the Inquisitor stressed?
He is stressed.
Yeah. So he's stressed to focus?
I believe
he
so.
He pushed the limit to focus.
Yeah, so he's, yeah, that's what I'm asking. He pushed to focus?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. That's the, instead of getting the free evade, he's not been putting it down. So.
That must have been on the shawl.
That was on the shawl.
Mike has actually forgotten that the one title does that.
So, yeah. Bill?
100.
Yeah. 100 for Bill, 47 for Clay.
I don't know. 47. Yeah.
The Inquisitor pushed the limits to focus after a target lock. Well, keep up with the commentary.
Yeah, but he didn't do it yet, so. Well, it looks like he's shy of tokens.
Yeah. Yep. Inquisitor's held that now.
I believe he took two shields. Early and just still on.
So
two hull.
I don't believe it's an error in state of play because he pushed to focus in and the evade action is an option.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's what I've been doing with Palpatine.
The focus token was next to his ship and then he spent it.
Yep.
Was that not a focus token?
Well,
is that next to Inquisitor? I thought it was.
Inquisitor? Spent it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm sure he took a focus. Patrick's saying it was an evade, but I don't know.
If it was an evade, then he pushed the limit to evade, which he can't
do.
Yeah, so. That's why it would be an error instead of play.
Yeah.
But I thought it was a focus.
Yeah. The dial's all been placed now, so. I mean, I'm not going to interfere in a game where they're not asking for it. We know what the list does, Patrick, but if a player's do it wrong, what do you want us to do? Should we play the game for them?
Yeah. Players have to remember.
See, the thing is, the evade is
ability.
You perform a free evade action, so
yeah.
If a player does not do so, that is a missed opportunity,
yeah.
Not an error. Play. Well, it isn't. It is something the player should not do. But there is a case where you might not want to do it, right? Because, well, what if there's Pale?
Yeah.
I've only made that mistake once.
And of course it is May, since there is that edge case where you might not want to do it. After all.
Right.
Well, that Inquisitor looks like about as good shape as it is. Missing that wing.
So pushing for tight lock. See if he remembers it. Yeah, so he's taking the evade this time. We've still got Palpatine here, so it's. And it looks like Wampa should have a range 3 shot.
I think so. He's going for Wampa.
Yeah. So, 4 hits. So, Palpatine 1, spend the evade on the other one, and Wampa lives. But it was a good choice from Aiden.
Yeah, forces the use of Palp, so.
Yep.
Yep. Or at least more likely to force the Palp use.
Yeah. So there's a crit in there, so it's a point of damage on dash at the very least.
Yep.
And depending on what he rolls.
Oh, so he evaded it?
Yeah, he rolled to evade, so the crit wasn't going. Yeah.
Dash is at 1.
Yep.
The end is nigh.
Well, the Inquisitor has an easier time lining up a shot this time from Dash's positioning, depending on how quickly Dash runs. The problem Aiden's going to have is that the Inquisitor's always going to be shooting first.
Yep.
And
always range two, one.
Yeah.
It's a D20. D20 here. What a rolling.
Critical hit.
So
it was a 20.
Calvin randomly picks up a D20, rolls it, and gets a 20. Shall we try? A 3. Yeah. I'm happy about it. It wasn't a 1. There were 2 numbers on that die worse than that. Yeah,
you infected it.
Jeez, Chris.
Oh, I used to play D&D with the most dice superstitious people. They actually believed in the whole dice infection thing. Don't touch my dice, you'll give me your bad luck. I don't believe I've ever seen that in...
You can't prove it wrong. You cannot disprove that you give someone bad luck by touching a die.
We'd have to take
first
that
time I ever did it to that person
and then roll it like a million
I just said just
times
roll the bloody die and
show
and
that
he ended up getting a critical
still
hit out of it. I haven't seen that much in X-Wing though, like the whole don't touch my dice.
I don't know. I've not seen it,
but I'm just saying I haven't.
Yeah.
Don't touch my regional dice.
I don't have any regional.
They look like they should be liquid.
You sold them.
Yeah. An icky liquid.
They were terrible. There is no excuse for Whisper not to be able to hit a barn door with a target lock focus at range 1.
That's the dice's fault.
Yeah. So we go.
Just learn to roll better.
I'll take my $130.
Wow. Some people are crazy enough to pay that. Clearly.
Oh,
seriously? That's what it said it's going for?
No, it's Canadian. That's what I got.
Still. I know,
that's cheap.
Like $20 American.
That's cheap. I gave the guy a good deal. A deal. A steal. A sale of a effing Sentry.
Alright, the shuttle's coming around. The shuttle's going to finish him off.
Yeah.
Forget
so
one per
going,
Inquisitor.
The shuttle's going to be relevant again real quick. So that straight maneuver that I was leery of does seem to have actually worked out pretty well for him, so here you go.
I don't know if I like that.
Well, landing right in front of the debris.
It's range 1, but it's obstructed, unmodified.
He's only gotta get 1, right?
Well, he does, but I guess Dash is...
Did he put the evade token down again? I can't see one.
He barrel rolled and boosted, so no. It would
have
been cheating.
Oh, he's still got the target lock.
I guess he does have the target lock.
Yeah, didn't need to throw it, so...
So he Palpatines it?
Needs to roll 1.
Oh,
3.
Triple one.
And that is that. A 100.
And that's
to
why
40.
Everybody loves Imperial A-holes.
How much did Aiden destroy?
40.